Join us online at charlierose.com. Characterize yourself as a climber. I mean, climbers differ. They're like all other athletes differ.
Yeah, I've been known, or people say that I'm a very conservative and cautious climber.
They do. And I'm asking, is that true?
It's true. And I'm happy about that because it is a risky arena, and it's about managing the risk and being smart and being patient. And also what I say is listening to the mountain, knowing when to go up, when to stop, and when to go down.
Is it primarily about weather?
Typically, yes. Snow conditions and weather. That's the big reason for not succeeding in the mountains.
The snow conditions meaning the possibility of avalanches? Or
yes, if the weather gets bad and it's windy and it's snowing, you can have severe avalanche conditions, and you need to be aware of that. And you can create an avalanche because then you become a trigger.
You were within 300 feet of the top of, was it Mount Everest?
Yes.
And said, I'm not going to the top.
Yeah, it was my first attempt. And
within 300 feet.
Yeah.
It's the size of a football field.
Right. And you're looking at the
top.
You
can see it.
And
you,
that's...
You planned for it for a year or all your life. Or...
Right. But you have to... We evaluated the conditions and we realized that the way the weather was changing, we would probably get to the top, but we probably wouldn't get down.
And you have this famous line you have, which is...
Getting to the summit is optional, getting down is mandatory. And it has to be a round trip, you know? It doesn't count if you just get to the top. And I think that's what separates people that know the art of mountaineering.
Join us online at charlierose.com.